attend a press introduction for a Japanese motorcycle and you'll never hear talk of the designer. Nothing against the Erik Buells, David Robbs and Pierre Terblanches of this world, but in Japan, drawing attention to oneself is considered boastful. Designing and building a motorcycle is a team effort, and it is treated as such. So while you may hear the project leader at the back of the room introduced by a company spokesperson, after which he may get up to give a brief technical presentation, you won't ever see him posing for photos and signing autographs. That would be poor manners. So it's notable that the man behind Honda's successful CBR 900RR series and its successors, the 929 and 954, did step out of the shadows into the limelight. Tadao Baba was able to do so not only because he spoke excellent English, but because he was an engaging individual with some truly interesting things to say. Chief among these was his bigger circle theory, which he explained at the 1998 press introduction for the third generation CBR 900RR. On a piece of paper, Baba sketched two axes, one representing intended usage and the other riderability, and then on top of those, various sized circles that showed where each year's CBR was positioned. The goal, he explained, was an ever bigger circle, meaning a bike that novice street riders would find unintimidating yet expert racers could win on. When Baba retired last year reportedly following a round-the-world retirement party, the bigger circle theory went with him. But not just because he was gone, the timing coincided with a major shift in design parameters. Where previous CBRs were meant first and foremost as street bikes, the RC45 and RC51 serving as the basis for Honda's racing superbikes, this year the CBR 1000RR will fill that role. Predictably, its circle would get smaller. And so it's no surprise to learn that the new project leader, Kunet Akihara,
thanks for watching and subscribe.